Alright guys, just to let you know, the Mobile Beach Show will be taking place once again this year in Las Vegas. This time, it's not in the Riviera, it's in the Tropicana Hotel. It'll be taking place from the 14th till the 17th of March 2016. There's the website, I'll put a link in the description. Also put a link in the description to this book, and also there could be an icon around about there which will take you to a rather good video from Mr. Lenny Fontana. Now, first of all, this book here, Running a Successful Wedding DJ Business. It's not what you do, it's how you do it. Now, this book is put together by Mr. John Beck and Derek Pengelly. Now, Mr. John Beck will be at the Mobile Beach Show in Vegas this year. I'm not sure about Derek Pengelly, quite possibly. I've read it and it is very good. I'm going to give you a couple of tips from this book. Without having to look at it, I've got quite a good memory when it comes to really good tips. Now, one is, oh, what was that tip again? Forgot, that's right. Sorry. Is about pricing. Now, let's imagine you go into a car showroom and in front of you is a chap trying to sell you a car. Now, let's put yourself in the position of the bride and groom or bride phoning you up. But I'm going to give you an analogy first. So you walk into a car showroom and the person comes up to you, says, hello, Mr. and Mrs. Who, whatever, what are you interested? And you say, I like that car over there. Can you tell me a little bit about it? The chap or lady then takes you to that vehicle and they say, yes, it's a Ford something or other. A lot of people are probably thinking, oh, yeah, I'd walk away. Just, oh, shut up, will you? It's a Ford whatever. And it's got, it's red. It's got a 5-litre engine. And it's £25,000. Now, at that point, I'll be thinking, £25,000, that's a lot of money. Oh, dear, can we afford it? For the rest of the conversation, I'm going to be thinking about the price. I'm quite possibly going to be completely ignoring what that lady or man is saying, explaining about the wonderful parts of the car and what it can do. Not what it can't do, what it can do. All I'm going to be thinking about is the cost. So my mind's on something else. Now let's take that analogy to the DJ industry. You have a client phone you up on the phone. Hello, I'm interested in booking you as a DJ. Now, of course, first and foremost, before any of that, what you're going to be doing is looking in your diary to confirm that you can do that date. The last thing you want to do is run through all the rigmarole of what you can give them, only to find out you're booked. And if that happens, then you're a bit of a numpty and an idiot, because you should be making sure you know that you can or can't work on that day anyway. But put that analogy where DJing is concerned. The last thing you do is give them the price in the first 30 seconds. What you do is you explain what you can give them first. In other words, you butter it up. In other words, a big table full of lovely food. People are looking at that thinking, wow, this is amazing. Once they've seen it, they know what they can have. Then you give them the price. You don't give them the price first before they walk in and see the food, because they're going to be thinking about the price and go, we can't really afford this. Think about it. The next one is getting people on the dance floor. How do you do it? Well, one way is the snowball effect. Very simple. You're playing a track. You invite two people on the dance floor. If you can't get at least two people on the dance floor, then you're a fool. If you can't physically get them to come up, then you go and get them. That's a completely another story. But once you have two people on the dance floor, it's all in this book, by the way, you stop the music after a couple of minutes, you invite them to split and go and get another person each, meaning you have four. After a minute or so, you get those four. You get 8, 16, 32, and so on. The next one is the tossing of the bouquet and or the garter. Do it separately or together. Another great way of getting people on the dance floor is to invite all the single ladies onto the dance floor. You throw the bouquet, play some music straight away. You've got them. The other one is the garter. Of course, you can make it a little bit more interesting by wrapping it around a football, a basketball, maybe get a pot, maybe get some people to put like £5, £10 in there, or dollars, $20, and then throw it. Makes it a little bit more interesting. Tips like this are in this book. It's full of it. go and check it out. I'll put a link in the description also to Amazon. So there will be the icon to the Lenny Fontana interview in this video. There will also be information on the Mobile Beat Show, which is just over there. I'll be there representing V-Moda, and I'll be helping V-Moda sell their V-Moda headphones. So if you are interested, you've heard of V-Moda, come and check them out. If you're not sure about them, by all means, bring your headphones you use at the moment, and you can do a demo in between the two. You can see what they're like, at least, all right? And you can purchase the V-Moda products as well, all right? So I'll finish off with Practice and Enjoy, and hopefully see you there. Thank you. Take it easy, and don't forget, check this out.